Hi everybody, it's Chris and welcome back to another video. I thought today I'd share with you my favourite new wave of British heavy metal tracks and try and put them into some kind of rank order. So I've got 20 songs for you and there are four rules here. And the first one is, they're my favourites. They're not necessarily the best. They're not necessarily the most lauded tracks of this particular era, but they're just kind of, if you like, nostalgic picks. And they're going to come from a three-year period, 79 through to 81. After that point, I kind of lost a little bit of interest in this particular movement. Now, I've only allowed myself one track from any one band. That stops me putting in loads of Iron Maiden or Diamond Head into the list. And I've got to have a physical copy to show, actually. So that means I won't show, actually, some of my favourite songs from this particular era, sadly. So for example, Hollow Ground's Flying High, or Saturday Night Special by High Treason, or Axe Crazy by Jaguar, or Riding High by Persian Risk. All of those probably would have made it into my top 20. And in fact, in my top 10, I definitely would have had Blitzkrieg by Blitzkrieg, and I wish I had a copy of that. It goes for a lot of money and it's really hard to find. So I can only really rank the ones I've got as such, or the ones I like the most from the ones I've got, because I've got quite a big collection, actually. And I'm going to start off at number 20 with Samson and Vice Versa. Samson had Bruce Dickinson as their vocalist prior to his move to Iron Maiden. He was called Bruce there. And on the cover, we've got Thunderstick, who was very much the face of the new wave of British heavy metal. There he is on the front of their second album, Head On, from where Vice Versa, backed with Hammerhead, comes from. So there's number 20 from Samson. A band I don't know anything about, actually. The band are called Zero and the track is called Cutting Loose. And there are two versions of this, actually. It's really catchy. You've got a great guitar solo. The first version comes from Metal for Mothers, Volume 2. This came out in 1980 and was a fairly quick follow-up from the seminal Metal for Mothers compilation that came out, I think, in the same year. Great song, Zero, Cutting Loose. Really good song. It features on this as well, the Friday Rock Show compilation. And I think this is the better of the two versions. And we'll... this one, actually, for our number 18. And at number 18, I've got Irish band Sweet Savage, which features Vincent Campbell, who went on to play with Dio just after this, I think, and then now with Def Leppard. And the song in question is called Eye of the Storm. It's a great rocker, really heavy, actually. He also did a track called Killing Time, which is really good as well. And you can see why Metallica sound like they do when you hear songs like that. So there's Sweet Savage and Eye of the Storm at number 18. At number 17, we've got Raven and Don't Need Your Money. This is on Neat Records. This is a power trio from Newcastle, I think. Almost like a visionary band, actually, as proto-thrash metal. Really influential band. Now, this is different from the version that appears on their first album, actually. It's kind of slightly rawer, I think. Great thrash riff on it, though. So there's Raven and Don't Need Your Money. Good stuff. Uh, Next up at number 16, we've got all-female band Girls School. I saw this lot play, actually, a couple of times, actually, I saw them open for Uriah Heep in 1981, and I'm pretty sure they opened the concert with this particular track, which is Come On, Let's Go. It's the opening song from their album Hit and Run. Great song. Is it their best one? No, probably not, but it's the one that I one of my favourites by them, I think. Okay, that was number 16. Number 15, we've got a band that I saw at Reading in 1980. There were a number of bands I'm mentioning today, actually, that did feature. This is like the new wave of British heavy metal Reading Festival, actually. And the band in question are Budgie, who weren't really new wave at all. They've been around since the early 70s, but they changed their sound, actually, when they put a new guitarist in. And the song in question is Wildfire. In fact, I could have had Panzer Division Destroy. That's also really good, both of which they played at Reading that year. So that's Budgie and Wildfire at number 15. Vardis and 100 Miles an Hour, the title track from this particular album. A power trio featuring the barefooted Steve Zodiac, great name, on guitar. It's like fast biker metal, complete with an unaccompanied guitar solo, and it's got little bits of it which are kind of like speeded up Voodoo Child. It's a great track, actually. So that's 100 Miles an Hour by Vardis. Recorded live, that one. At number 13, we've got a band that features someone who went on famously to play in Def Leppard. He was Phil Collin, and originally he was in the band Girl, and the track in question is My Number. So I think this is their debut single, actually, from 1979. Now, I saw Girl, and they supported Def Leppard, interesting enough, and I love My Number. It's a really simple, kind of moody number. They're different, actually, to the average new wave of British heavy metal. They're quite glam influenced, and they did have a different sound. And in fact, this album, Sheer Greed, is pretty good, actually. So well worth seeking out. But that's my number 13, My Number by Girl. Number 12, we've got a real classic, actually, and sometimes quite hard to find. This is Mithra and the Death and Destiny EP. And the first side of this, which has got Death and Destiny and Killer. Killer is wonderful. This is 1979, I think. Northeast band, again, a really big influence on Metallica, but a wonderful first side of a single. Both songs are great. Killer's probably my favourite. That's Mithra. We'll be right back. 7, we've got another band, I think, from the Northeast, actually. And this is also on Neat Records. This is White Spirit and Backs to the Grind. But it's the B-side that I love the most, called Cheetah. Both of those songs don't feature on their album, actually. It's very, very Deep Purple-esque. In fact, Cheetah sounds like a Gillan track. And then when you find out that Yannick Gers was playing on here and he went to play in Gillan afterwards, you can kind of see why it sounds like it does. But that's White Spirit and Cheetah, the B-side of Backs to the Grind. We've got a band I don't really know much about, but they were on the Metal for Mothers compilation, and that's Trespass with a song called One of These Days. Wrong side. Real Thin Lizzy influenced band, actually, but this is a great song, really is. That's my 10th place song, One of These Days by Trespass. You close your mind and you walk away. Sit and listen to the radio. At number 9, we've got the Tigers of Pangtang. This is from their debut album, and the track in question is called Killers. It closes side 1. I think this is their best album. It's the most new wave of British heavy metal. They're a much cleaner sounding band when John Sykes turns up in the next one, Spellbound. This is great. This is, so Killers is quite, and the title's very similar, obviously, but it's very Maiden-esque. It's got that galloping bass, great riffing, great soloing, dreadful but charming vocal delivery. Really of the time, I would have said, but this is a really good album, and Killers is a great song from the Tigers of Pantang. And band I don't really know anything about. The band's called Dark Star. I know they're a Birmingham band, and this is Lady of Mars. It might actually be their only song, I don't know. It's a great song though. Really nice sort of up-tempo boogie kind of track, actually. Keyboards, harmonies, quite complex for the new wave of British heavy metal, but a really great song, and that's my number 8, Lady of Mars by Dark Star. At number 7, we've got a band, again, I don't know anything about, and I don't know if they did anything else, but I absolutely love this. And it's a track that features on this album here, Metal Explosion. And this is tracks from the Friday Rock Show. And the track in question is Paper Chaser by Taurus. It's like a forgotten classic. Twin guitars, insane guitar solos. It's about 5.5 minutes long, I think. The last 2.5 minutes is a guitar solo. It's absolutely brilliant. So this is a great album, but Paper Chaser by Taurus is an absolute classic. Number 6, we've got the opening track from the second album from the band from Barnsley, and that's Saxon from the album Wheels of Steel and Motorcycle Man. The live version is also very good, but the studio is brilliant. It's so heavy, wonderful stuff, takes me back to that era. And seeing them do that live, but wonderful track. That's Motorcycle Man from Saxon from Wheels of Steel. at number five, top five now, so we're getting onto the big boys, I think, anyway. This is Angel Witch, and the track in question is their title track, Angel Witch, which they did bring out on a single. I can probably do without the chanting bit of it, but, oh, wonderful stuff. This is a great album. I nearly chose Sweet Danger, actually, but Angel Witch just edges it for me. That's from 1980, I think. Number four, we've got a band who are much, much softer, actually, Praying Mantis, and their heaviest song, Panic in the Streets. I saw this band support Triumph. They were really, really good back in 1980. I also saw them at the Reading Festival in 1980 as well. I could have chosen Lovers to the Grave with a kind of slow song with a guitar solo, or the beautiful harmonies of Flirting with Suicide, but I've gone with their heavier track, Panic in the Streets, which on this single, live version of it, is really good as well. I know that Joe Elliott, the lead singer of Def Leppard, hates being associated with the new wave of British heavy metal, but I have to include one song from them because they were one of the first bands I saw of this particular movement. So I'm going to choose a track from the debut album from Def Leppard. I nearly went with Wasted because the riff is brilliant. I nearly went with Get Your Rocks Off, which was their opening single on Bludgeon Raffola Records. But I've eventually gone for The Overture, which is a real Thin Lizzy inspired song, and it just sounds so new wave of British heavy metal. I love that song, it's brilliant stuff. At number two, we've got Iron Maiden, and which one? Well, I've gone for Phantom of the Opera, quintessential Iron Maiden, twin leads, galloping bass, got those speed changes. I mean, there's a number of songs you could have chosen on here, but that is absolutely fantastic example of the new wave of British heavy metal from, I think, probably one of their best albums, if not the best album. But from the new wave of British heavy metal, undoubtedly for me anyway, was the White Album by Diamond Head. And I suppose, you know, people are going to be thinking, oh, he's going to choose Am I Evil? I'm not, actually. I'm going to choose Helpless. That track for me, with its riffing and its drums and the kind of twin guitar, a fantastic little guitar solo from Brian Tatler, I just love it. I mean, this album is just immense anyway. I could have chosen loads of tracks from here. It was the B-side, actually, of Shoot Out the Lights. I did meet the band, actually, so I've got it signed by Brian Tatler and Sean Harris, and it was the B-side of that. You know, I think it was a shorter version, I can't remember, but just a wonderful song, and that's my favourite, or at least it is today, one of my favourites from the new wave of British heavy metal. In the comments below, what are your favourites from that particular time? Is there ones that I've really missed out? There's a few up here I probably should have included, but hey, these are my favourites right now. So thank you very much for watching. Thank you for commenting if you do, and thank you for subscribing if you do. And if you don't, I'd love to have earned your support with this particular video. Anyway, I'll be back sometime soon with another video. Cheers.